In an incredible state of pain and anguish, and I can tell you, you will not understand. You will not understand the state in which I have found myself these past 6 weeks. No one will understand. No one will understand. I want to say that a million times. Nobody will understand how I feel. I don't even understand how I feel. It is too much for me. My brother and I had this intense and strong bond, which we developed as a defense mechanism. We found ourselves while growing up, as a defense mechanism against the very unfavorable conditions and circumstances we found ourselves while growing up as kids. It was not easy. I remember my brother would always say of our children, look at them, they are coming to enjoy after we have suffered. And that's the truth. Our own was not a case of being born with a silver spoon in your mouth. No. We had to sweat it out. We had to work it out by the grace of God. So that bond came on as a defense mechanism against the circumstances and conditions we found ourselves. So, well, it's like that's the only way we survived as children. Being together at all times, standing for one another at all times. It was so bad. We could have only done that to survive. That's how we stuck together. We were seriously involved in the life events of each other. He played a major role in my life. I played a major role in his life growing up. It was such that
Thank you very much. Once again, can we put our hands together for the Government House Choir for this beautiful rendition? Thank you so much. Well, We're enjoying this solemn night. May I invite to perform a short play directed by Kelvin Melvin Sampson called The Eulogy.
Greetings to you, children of the earth, and welcome to tonight's story. Not your regular super story, not myth, nor superstition, but a story about a legend. A legend who now sits in steads of the gods.
The mighty bird has fallen. Indeed, an eagle has fallen. And the earth rumbles and quick, as all and sundry quiver and quick. It is indeed a sad tale, sour and still.
The sky is bloody and cold.
bereaved that are grieved in their tears of blood.
The emeritus professor has sojourned on the journey of eternity.
Why you take our father?
That she ain't no good old. Why you take our father? That she ain't no good. Why you take our teacher? That she ain't no good.
Trembling child. On the 22nd of February 1944, this man kissed the earth welcome. I remember.
The journey of this world begins with a struggle. The struggle for life in the face of death. So the journey of a man begins with the travails of childbirth.
Listening to the anguish and perils of her voice, piercing through the eardrums. Pain has always been the consequence of pleasure.
But surely, after this pain, comes the uncontrollable joys of motherhood. That is the cry of a newborn and the laughter of a mother. A new child is born. There must be festivity. The whole clan shall gather together in solidarity and celebrate. It is an age-long tradition that binds us together in unity.
Let it be known today, the sun has smiled on us, and we shall celebrate.
When I never can pray, and it would be me, okay, pray, and it would be me, open my pray, and it would be me, okay, pray, and it would be me. Okay, pray, and it would be me, open my pray, and it would be me, okay, pray. Okay, pray and it will be me. Okay, pray and it will be me. Open my pray and it will be me. Okay, pray and it will be me. Okay, pray and it will be me. Open my pray and it will be me.
The journey of this young lad begins. He must survive.
There is a voice of many generations and the eminent solution to the problems of many generations. And so, he grew in strength and wisdom and would be capable of leading a kingdom. Living the life of a leader. Dinkba, a transgenerational leader, but his glorious future began with the struggle to be educated.
Nimi Dinkba Briggs had his early education at Umoni Grammar School Abonima and Baptist High School Port Harcourt. Later, he enrolled at Government College Umahia, where he completed his secondary education.
He then proceeded for his tertiary education. And so night after night, he kept the candle of hope burning. Others slept for a little while. He stayed up and tarried for a little while. He kept his zeal and passion burning. Others refused to suffer. But he endured his long suffering because persistence and determination was all he needs to offer to save his generation from suffering. And so he became friends with the night. And in June 1969, he received his bachelor's degree in medicine and surgery from the University of Lagos, Nigeria. Nimi Briggs expanded his capacity and enlarges his coast. Professor Nimi Briggs, a first-hand Nigerian academic scholar, an emeritus professor in obstetrics and gynecology. Nimi Briggs served as Vice Chancellor of the University of Port Harcourt twice, from 1995 to 1996, and 2000 until 2006.
Rave in these academics, in thought this great gallery of an epochal and quintessential academia. This is the walking walk of art, vintage beyond valuation, beyond forgery or imitation.
Decades since that trembling dream and vision first tiptoed into the storied stage of the academics. Dream undeterred, vision crystal clearer, Professor Nimi Briggs, the living work of art.
He received a National Service Act of Bravery Award for his military duty during the Nigerian Civil War. He fought for the unity of Nigeria during the 30-month-long Nigerian Civil War, when he served as field captain, medical officer with the Nigerian Army at the Field 3 Ambulance of Division 3, Nigerian Army.
He's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow, for he's a jolly good fellow. And so say all of us.
Publications and academic contributions are uncountable, to mention but a few. His professional and academic achievements include member of the Royal College of Obstetrics and Gynecologists, London.
Fellow!
He's pro-chancellor of Alex Ekwueme Federal University, Ndofe Alike. He's chairman.
Evaluation. Full registration as a medical practitioner. General Medical and Dental Council of Nigeria. Educational Council for Foreign Medical Graduates. And valedictory lectures, over 18 books published, over 39 consultancy to government and non-governmental organizations.
Contributed to the national development with the treatment of patients with vesical vaginal fistula and pioneering the campaign for safe motherhood in northern Nigeria. Appointed member of a 10-person advisory committee to assist the Nigerian University Commission in its determination to urgently revitalize the Nigerian university system.
Thank you.
winning the ball. Crack, 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 ball. Aloha. Dynamo. Why are we here? Tamuno. Aninimiye. Imiete. Imiete. When it now, when it can water my when it does remember. Dynamo when it double. Dynamo. Dynamo.
Tears. Rise up and look beyond his death. Ask yourself, will I be remembered when I die? What exactly will people remember me for? Our emeritus professor lived a life worthy of emulations. It might be hard to accept his demise, but he has left a legacy. Legacy that has immortalized him and have his name encrypted forever in our hearts. Rejoice! Celebrate the epochal icon, Emeritus Professor Mimi Dipa Briggs. You are a legend. Legends can never die.
Legends can never die.
Away, away, away.
Shooting from the stars.
Away, away, away.
When you were from the stars, no one can play your part. Legends can never die.
Away.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please can we put our hands together one more time for this wonderful artwork? What better way to eulogize a legend? Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, at this time, may I invite for a special presentation, Precious Omuku.
Last night I lay sleeping, there came a dream so fair. I stood in old Jerusalem beside the temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sang, methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rung. Methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rung. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, hark how the angels sing. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna to your King.
thought my dream was changed. The streets no longer rang. Hushed with the glad hosanna, the little children sang. The sun grew dark with mystery. The morn was cold and chill, as the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. As the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, lift up your gates and sing. There seemed to be. I saw the holy city beside the tideless sea. The light of God was on his street. The gates were open wide, and all who would might enter, and no one was denied. No need of moon or stars by night, or sun to shine by day. It was the new Jerusalem that would not pass away. Was the new Jerusalem that would not pass away. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, sing for the night is so.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Prof enjoyed all of that. All of that. You know, the drama was about the life of Emeritus Professor Nimi Dinkpa-Briggs. You could see those students, some of them were talking with so much authority as if they were there when it happened. Some of them are just in 100 level. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to invite to the microphone for a special presentation, Precious Omuko. Permit me to invite to the microphone Dr. Abie Hector Goma for his own tribute, please. Dr. Abie.
Good evening, our fathers and mothers, my peers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I'm here speaking on behalf of my family, my colleagues, the medical alumni at home and abroad, and a lot of doctors, and as well as the Nigerian community in Leeds and beyond in the United Kingdom. Let me start with a very quick story which happened about 3 weeks before 11-11-11. I called our late prof, and at that time he was part of a Nigerian delegation to China with then President Jonathan. And he said, Abi, I'll call you back. And a few minutes later he called me and I said, Dad, 11-11-11 will be my 17th wedding anniversary. And he just said, okay, I'll come. And 3 weeks later, he just took a business class flight to Leeds, and he was there with us for 3 weeks with mom, and he flew right back to Port Harcourt. Nothing else. He just came to celebrate with us. And that's the kind of person that Emeritus Professor Nimi Briggs was. He invested in people. I looked at his valedictory lecture on the 23rd of February 2009, Women's Health, a Nation's Wealth, and permit me to read from it. It said, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I'm done, and so what is left is for me to thank you all for your presence and also to express my deep indebtedness to all those who have contributed in one way or the other to making me what I am today. You're far too many for names to be mentioned, but even at that, two women stand out. My mother, for the awesome sacrifice she made, as well as our tenacity, even in the face of palpable hopelessness, in ensuring that I did not have a wasted life. And my wife, Lady D, as she is popularly called, for being the gem of inestimable value, whose radiance and incandescence glow brightest when tribulations strike. Thank you, Mom. I know tribulation has struck, and you keep smiling. Thank you for sharing that with all of us, Nina, Kika, Boma, Toju, Tassie, and the rest of the family. Thank you for sharing that with us. There are three quotes I would have liked to quote, but because time is not on my side, I just want to quote one of them. And you can see these quotes in nimibriggs.org/quotes. He said, behind the well-known medical causes of death from torrential genital tract hemorrhage, generalized convulsions and systemic infections, amongst others, that kill women in and around pregnancy, there is a less well-appreciated wider web of poverty, ignorance, and general underdevelopment that underpin the large number of maternal deaths in Nigeria. In a lot of our conversations in the last days, we knew that, or we talked about it, that health is equal to development. And everywhere there is underdevelopment, there is poor health. I want to finish by challenging our leaders in Nigeria, particularly those of us who were here, that let us do the right thing. The right thing is about food for people, jobs for people, education for children, health for mothers and babies. In the United Kingdom, Professor Michael Marmot talks about giving every child the best start in life. If every child has a good start in life, then they are going to become healthy. Our dear father lived his life trying to make health a better place, a better thing for everyone. And let us all do the right thing and put funds where they will be to make life better for mothers, for babies, for young people, for men and women. Then the health of Nigerians will be better. And if we're able to do that and do the right thing wherever we are, then the legacy of late Emeritus Professor Nimi Dinkpa Briggs will be established. Thank you all for listening, and God bless you all.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, when the sister was talking or speaking earlier, Dr. Mrs. Nengia, she made mention of something. She said, Prof attended events too early. He never went for any event late. As a matter of fact, there was one wedding I was anchoring last year, At about 11 a.m., as the MC, I was already at the venue together with the DJ and the ushers. I just turned and saw Prof seated. I was tempted. I almost walked up to him to remind him that, sir, you are Professor Nimi Briggs. You cannot be here. You came too early. They've not even joined the couple. He went for event too early. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, to take us further, I want to call on Professor Dagogo Fubara for his tribute. Professor Dagogo Fubara. In the next 3 minutes, let's hear from Prof.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I salute you all coming to honor our departed brother and friend. In the past 2 decades or more that incidentally, please, may I invite all old boys of Government College of Maya to come to the stage, because after my tribute, I want us to render the college anthem in honor of our departed old boy. All old boys of Government College of Maya, please come up to the stage. And the old girl, on the young girls too, young girls of Government College of Maya. Well, when the British ruled Nigeria, one of the things they did was to build in each of the regions, west, east, north, and the middle, carbon copy of their own type of secondary school. And Maya, Government College of Maya, was one of those 4. And the brother we are honoring his departure today went to that school. So you permit me for asking our old boys to come and join in honoring him as I make my tribute. And in particular, you see, my prefect, when I was in class 1, this was my prefect, and he's here. I salute you for coming. 92. Well, at age 85, I have never witnessed a night of songs and tributes for anybody like what I have seen this night. and your presence and all we have seen, give me no room to have anything more to say as a tribute to our departed Professor Emeritus Dinkpa Nimisere Briggs. Well, the few things I want to say to add to all that you've already heard is that in our lifetime before he departed, in the past about 25 years, I don't know anybody that outside my family, my children, that I have congenially interacted like I did with Nimisere Dinkpa Briggs. Our interaction was so strong, and I beg, pardon me, some people used to say we were husband and wife. But you know, we were both males, and we are not in that category. But that's how close we were together in life. Consequently, his departure to be with his maker has so shattered me that I really have lost the composure to effectively and properly eulogize him. You've heard a lot. The man was a brilliant, glowing star, like the Northern Pole star in the Milky Way of the universe. He was a trailblazer in everything he did in life. In academics, he was a trailblazer. As an educationist, he was a trailblazer. As an administrator, he was a trailblazer. In mentoring people, he was a trailblazer. And he was a towering medical practitioner as professor of obstetrics and gynecology, through which I can't count how many women and babies' lives he saved in that profession. He was a community leader by excellence. And whatsoever was pure, whatsoever was noble, whatsoever was right, whatsoever was lovely and admirable, we saw these excellent and praiseworthy virtues in the life of our departed colleague, Mary Emeritus Professor Nimisere Dinkpa Briggs. All I can say is I pray that the Sovereign Lord God Almighty will grant both his family and all of us, his friends, the grace and fortitude to bear his departure. And to conclude in trying to honor him, the old boys of Government College Umuahia, his alma mater, will now render the first verse of our school anthem. Mm-hmm. May God grant his soul eternal repose in the bosom of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Okay, please let me just use this opportunity to invite the Royal Met Choir for their rendition. Okay, they said they have done it already, so we'll take that as their presentation. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I want to invite Royal Met Choir, they said Prof was their patron for 30 years. 30 years. They are supposed to celebrate their 30th year of existence. But you are still 30. You are still 30. The Royal Met Choir.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, here is Royal Met Choir, a choir that started with a pioneer patron in person of our late prof with which we are gathered for today. This man, his goodness have helped a lot of us gain admission, not just admission, we've gained employment, not just that, he's helped a lot of us to get married, someone like me. This man was a good man. My song this night is saying, if you can help somebody, your living shall and will not be in vain. Happy listening. Thank you.
I can have somebody as I pass along, if I can cheer somebody with a word or a song, if I can show somebody when he's traveling wrong, then my living shall not be in vain. Then if I can do my duty as a good man ought, if I can bring back beauty to a world that's so rot, if I can preach love message just as Prof used to do, then my living shall not be in vain. Then my living shall not be in vain. Then my living shall not be in vain. If I can help somebody as I pass along, then my living shall not be in vain. Then my living shall not be in vain. Then my living shall not be in vain. If I can help somebody as I pass along, then my living shall not be in
tempest is raging.
tossing high. The sky is overshadowed with blackness. No shelter or help is nigh. Carest thou not that we perish? How canst thou lie asleep when each moment so madly is threatening a grave in the angry deep? The peace be still. Whether the wrath or the storm, or demons, or men, or whatever, say no water can swallow the ship. The master of ocean and
Calabari Ibialabo. This song was, you know, the lyrics we are supplied by our late father. So do this to end of this session. Calabari Ibialabo. Thank you.
Always known the Royal Mekwaya for for them to do a cultural song. Indeed, he was their patron for 30 years. A round of applause for them, please. Professor, Emeritus Professor Nimi Briggs had a smiling and non-intimidating face with a soft, reconciliatory, and convincing voice, which made him a successful diplomat and peacemaker. Was he a peacemaker? Ladies and gentlemen, permit me to invite to the microphone Foreman, a spoken word written by Joseph Ajenka and directed by Sunday Edom.
The Foreman is being performed by students of the Theatre Arts Department of the University of Port Harcourt.
An academic marshal, Nimi Dimpa Briggs, erudite, vibrant and full of energy. He took his bow when the ovation was loudest and reverberated through the land. A giant Iroko tree fell that stormy night, and shock, a deadly shock wave hit the land. And it caused an eclipse of the sun on Easter Monday.
the foreman. Four men in one. Superman who support the structure full of energy. The foreman makes things happen at the upbuilding. Highly experienced. The foreman diligently supervises the work of the workshop. The foreman wears coveralls. They are green mantles, fitting shoes uniquely jazzed that no one can attempt to fill. With the gifts of sharp intellect, emotional intelligence, insights and foresight, the foreman focuses their vision on the mission of transformation and progress. Our great foreman is what his name says, Nimi Sorie. Wisdom is also a name. But Dinkpa, a responsible, reliable, dependable man, a great man. Visionary and charismatic, he turned the tide of unique Uniports. There are many workers and just few supervisors, self-motivated, full of strength and activity. The foreman stands firm the chain of guidance of our faithful servants and allow themselves to be guided with streams of fine ideas. Prolific in productivity, prodigious in publication, the foreman produce amazing results.
With uncommon courage and commitment, the foreman, men four in one, fulfill their duties. With also trust in guidance, dedication, and clarity, they prayerfully pursue the ordained course. The four men leave giant footprints on the sands of times with legacies of reforms and transformations. Highly skilled and principled, very knowledgeable and endowed, working with speed and accuracy, serving with loyalty and devotion, no procrastination, no excuses, no dull moment, no idle time. Vibrant, the word active describes the activity of selfless service. The foreman insists on delivery on deadlines. Professor Emeritus Nimi Dinkpa Briggs was one of the few foremen of the hollow chambers of the intellect. A red gem, a precious gift, a wise foreman to the core. We celebrate his bountiful intellectual harvest. We celebrate his wise leadership. We celebrate his wide and deep administrative acumen. We celebrate his pattern life, his military gaze and discipline, his polish and punctuality. We celebrate his deep love for unique Uniports.
We celebrate his dignified culture of excellence. We celebrate his turning the tide of unique Uniports.
We celebrate
our prestigious beloved Vice Chancellor.
We celebrate
who puts us on the global map.
We celebrate.
We celebrate the doyen of university advancements.
We celebrate
meticulous in documentations and deadlines.
We celebrate
the gifts of oratory and warmth.
We celebrate
our Professor Emeritus.
We celebrate.
We celebrate.
Thank you very much. Please, can we put our hands together for them? Thank you. For them. The evening is far spent, so we'll be going straight to the tributes from the River State Government. And to give the tribute on behalf of the River State Government, may I invite Honorable Justice Adolphus Enebeli, Chairman RISEC. For the tributes, we'll be taking just 3 minutes for every tribute that will be given this evening. Just 3 minutes. Thank you.
the night is far spent. Let me just say, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. A few hours ago, I was asked to be here to render a tribute on behalf of Rivers State Independent Electoral Commission. They have broadened my duty to speak on behalf of Rivers State government. To render a tribute to a great soul as the Emeritus Professor Nimi Briggs is a no mean task. I have listened to previous speakers who rendered tribute for this great soul. They spoke glowingly and consolingly, and all in superlative or excellent terms, almost leaving me with no better word or adjective to describe the Emeritus Professor, now late. Speaking from the angle, first of all, of my present office as the chairman of RISEC, we have it on record that during his tenure as the second chairman of that body, he brought excellence to bear on administration. And in doing that, he maintained an admirable balance between the independence of RISEC, his professionalism, and the power play of political parties and politicians. He's a magnificent gentleman who, during that era, he made sure that due process was followed in all electoral processes and procedures to the ultimate end that in that period, River State, in all the 22 local government areas of River State, they had free, fair, credible election, I should add, relatively peaceful election in that period. If you talk about him from what all the previous speakers have said, he's a man of distinction, a detribalized academician. He towered high in ivory tower, firstly, in University of Port Harcourt that nurtured him. And from all that has been said here, he flew like the eagle to dizzy heights and even towered beyond the ivory tower that made him. He attained distinction in academia, distinction in all facets of administration, distinction in his area of specialization, obstetrics and gynecology. And from what was said here by Professor Dagogo Fubara, you can see that the Emeritus Professor was a medium through which procreation was brought in practical reality, and he made sure there are healing processes. He's a man who performed the corporal works of mercy. As I came in here at noon, I saw a lady bemoaning his demise, that here was a man who gave him money to feed his children, to attain the height they attained, and minister to the needs of widows just about 3 hours ago. That is the corporal works of mercy. Help the poor, feed the hungry, house those who don't have house, give job to the jobless, heal the sick, and above all, when a living man dies, the living one, survivors should lay him to rest. And what we are doing here is part of our corporate duty to our fellow human being, to lay the Emeritus Professor to rest. You can see, they say he has a smiling face. I agree entirely. From the study of physiognomy, human beings have two faces. An unsmiling face and a smiling face. Some smiling faces is just a false facade for a deceitful and wicked heart. But some unsmiling faces have good hearts. But we are fortunate that a medical professor has a smiling face, and behind it is a true and charitable heart. Nobody can argue about that. I have not known him intimately, but from what people say, what I've read about him, I have a brief banter with him some years ago, about 10 years ago, in a flight, Port Harcourt Abuja flight. I saw him seated by me. I recognize him as a senior citizen. I defer to him. I say, Prof, good afternoon. He said, who are you? I mentioned my name. I just say, I don't force anybody. Oh, you're a judge. I've heard about you. Sit down. I say, my seat is over there. It's okay. Very well. We shall see later. When we touched down at Abuja, he showed disarming humility of a kind. He was seated in front. I was at the back. Before he had a professor, emeritus professor, Nimi Briggs, turned back, walked towards where I was seated in the economy seat to shake me. That was the last I saw of him. I'm here now to carry on this not too pleasant, the unpleasurable task to render a tribute on his behalf. It's a gentleman's gentleman, to the core. He's always sporting sartorial elegance. I've never seen him without a suit. Well professionally turned out. And you can see a trendy hairstyle, permanent feature of him, a mien. He has admirable comportment. It's an epitome of humility. Ladies and gentlemen, if we continue to talk about him, there is nightfall, and there will be daybreak. We will not finish. I agree with all previous speakers. There are numberless things to say about him, but let what you have not said remain in the bosom of our heart. The question is, what will everybody be remembered for? Will I remember the late prof? And these good deeds will live beyond his time. All we pray for, let Mother Earth be soft on him wherever he lives, on this good and faithful servant. May the gentle soul of this great soul and other faithful departed rest in the bosom of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Sir, I liked when you said time is fast spent and you're going to take 3 minutes. Ladies and gentlemen, representing the Bayelsa State Government, I want to call for his tribute, Ambassador Igale. Please, let's stick to the 3 minutes, please. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. Your Excellency, the Governor of River State, this year represented, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I will try to stick to 3 minutes, but let me say that I wear several hats, which you may not see, and I'll make my remarks very brief. First, let me bring the greetings, very deep condolences of the governor and people of Bayelsa State to our kindred and fraternal people of River State on the loss of this our great brother. This is a very difficult time for our two states, and it also shows our deeply profound kinship. Today, as we are holding this event here, A similar event is holding in Yenagoa for Dr. Amber Mbawe, who was classmate of Professor Nimi Briggs at the University of Lagos and was Commissioner of Education in Rivers State. On Saturday, we lay to rest Senator Inatimi Spiff, who was Secretary to Government of Rivers State. And there was a big delegation from here. So it's a very difficult time for our two states, and the governor has asked me to bring his greetings. When the last governor of Bayelsa decided to establish a medical university, the vision, as he shared with some of us, who may not be in government but are considered people that could contribute some thoughts, was to establish an institution that will stand out in all of Nigeria to train young people in the medical sciences. And there was a search for a person to nurture this university, and that was how, from the east, the west, the north, and the south, the governor was directed to one man, and only one man, and that is Professor Nimi Briggs. That is how he became the pro-chancellor of the Bayelsa. My friend, I don't want to say, I'll speak very briefly, but I'm speaking, so I'll finish very briefly, don't worry. When you see me, you distract me. So now number two, he took this university as his child. He said, look, of everything I've done as a professor of medicine, to be pro-chancellor over this medical university, to train our children from Niger Delta, is my greatest task. And he did his best. Number two, I am here, not just on behalf of Rivers Bayelsa government, but on behalf of all the pro-chancellors of Nigerian universities. I am the pro-chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, Akure, in Ondo State. Professor Nimi Briggs was the pro-chancellor also of the Federal University at Lexikome University in Abakaliki. Previously was pro-chancellor of Federal University Lokoja. 2 years ago, we met to elect a chairman, and by consensus of everybody, he was nominated to be the chairman. He rejected it. He said, look, I'm 77 years old. Thank you, Professor Dago Fubara, for clapping. And everybody said, you must accept it. That at this critical time, we don't need anybody other person. You are the only person that can lead the over 200 pro-chancellors of all universities in Nigeria. And until he died, he was the chairman of all chairmen of all universities in Nigeria. Of almost everything we have said this evening, perhaps that is one of the greatest honor. And yesterday, let me say this, and I'm happy his wife was there, and the son Nina were there. Yesterday, Mr. President, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, joined other Nigerians in a similar event of tribute where Nigerians eulogized Professor Nimi Briggs. And it was moving for me, a person from this part of the country, because a lot of Northerners, people from the Southwest, people from the East, were crying. Some of these were people, aged professors, aged former ministers, former governors who are pro-chancellors, who are leaders of this country, and said, no other Nigerian deserves the kind of honor as Nimi Briggs. Nimi Briggs was not only a scholar. Nimi Briggs was not only a scholar. He was also involved in so many things at the same time. He was the chairman of the federal government's negotiation committee with the university unions. And many times, there was a particular time went to the president, the last year's strike, 9 months. At the 8th month, we said, no, let us go back to the president. And the president's position was firm. ASUU was firm. When we got there, and we sat before the president, President Nimi Briggs started. And when President Nimi Briggs finished, President Muhammadu Buhari said, I don't want to use the prepared speech I have. I've accepted everything you have said. We will end this strike. And that is how the strike ended. We may not know these details in the newspapers, but on an occasion like this, if I don't say it, I will not be happy with myself. Indeed, the country has lost. But for me, I believe that we have gained because his achievements stand for themselves. So I join those who have spoken to thank the Rivers State government for organizing this event and for you to know that his impact will remain not just in the university system, but in all of Nigeria. Thank you very much, and may so rest in peace.
Ambassador, your cufflink fell, and you are telling me you dashed me. How can you dash me one? Remove the other one, sir. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, permit me to invite to the microphone for their tribute, actually a representative from the University of Port Harcourt. A round of applause, please. In not more than 3 minutes, sir.
A very wonderful evening, ladies and gentlemen. I do know that they didn't manage this time well, unlike who Professor Briggs usually stands for. He's someone that's very timely. I want to give a tribute on behalf of my ninth Vice Chancellor, Professor Owunare Abraham Jojo. So much has been said about this true icon, an exemplary leader, and an avant-garde scholar to the core. Usually, a time of tribute is a time that people have lie about the life of others, that even when somebody did not live well, you see that people come to tribute and they begin to say all manner of good things about that person. But I stand here to say that all that has been said about Professor Briggs is nothing but the truth. He has touched lives in diverse ways and is indeed a destabilized Nigeria. It will amount to foolhardy to begin to write the lives and times of Professor Briggs on a piece of paper, because he's somebody that, you know, I see, and I don't even know the word to describe him. He has left a very big opening, a very big fallow at the University of Port Harcourt. And I wonder how we can fill such gap. Adieu to the fifth Vice Chancellor of the University of Port Harcourt. Adieu to the Provost of Provosts. Adieu to the Vice Chancellor of Vice Chancellors. Adieu to the Pro-Chancellors of Pro-Chancellors. Adieu, the husband of just one woman. Adieu, Professor Briggs. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please can we put our hands together one more time for him? May I now respectfully invite to give a speech the Governor of Rivers State, His Excellency Yesum Ezewonwike, CON. I beg your pardon. May I invite to give a tribute on behalf of the elder statesmen in Rivers State, Sir OCJ Okocha, OFR, SAN, DSSRS, JP.
Your Excellencies. Lady Data Briggs and all the members of the family of our late Emeritus Professor Nimi Dimpa Briggs. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I thank God that nobody tried to give me 3 minutes because I would have copied Ambassador Bolade Ighali's style and said, you can't time me. But someone has reminded us that Nimi Briggs, Alabo Prof, as I used to call him, was a very disciplined man. And for him, time was the essence of what he did. Time is money, and time indicates that we should take life seriously. And those who take life seriously try to be punctual in all that they do. Alabo Prof and I go back a long way, but perhaps the closest relationship we had was that of in-laws. My young nephew, Tunde, the son of my first brother-in-law, Chief Maxwell Tasi Amadi, married Professor Briggs' first daughter, Kika. Through that, we became very close. And he was an outspoken man. If he was not happy about anything, he would speak up. And he did speak up on one or two occasions. And Chief Maxwell and I, and me also, had to go and speak with him so that we could patch up things. He was also a peacemaker, as some of you may remember. One or two of us here were also members of a committee that he chaired that tried to make peace between two eminent Ikwere sons, the first one governor of Rivers State from 2007 to 2015, and the second one, the present governor of Rivers State. Mrs. Briggs will testify that we used to meet in their house in Amade Flats, trying to find a way forward, because we considered that if these two sons of Ikwere land were in good relationship, the sky would have been the limit for Rivers State. Federal presence, state presence. But then God knows best. It's a painful thing for me to always remember that this was an effervescent personality, ebullient character, an efficient workman. You've been told about his timekeeping. All of us knew him when he was Vice Chancellor. And he did his job with integrity and with zeal. But that is the way of all mortals, and we all too will go sooner or later. I want to say to Auntie, please, you and your children should take heart. Be consoled by the fact that all of us together are mourning with you. We can only ask God to grant Emeritus Professor Nimi Briggs' soul eternal rest in peace. Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. May I now respectfully invite to give a speech the Governor of Rivers State, His Excellency Yesum Ezewonwike, Commander of the Order of the Niger, Grand Service Star of Rivers State, Life Bencher, ably represented by the Secretary to the State Government, Dr. Tami Wenike Danagogo.
Your Excellencies, Deputy Governor-elect, the representative of Bayelsa State Government, the family of our revered Professor Nimi Briggs, distinguished elder statesmen, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I bring you the condolences and the felicitations of His Excellency, the Governor of River State, Chief Barrister Yesom Ezewonwike, CON. We know he holds Nimi Briggs in very high esteem and should have been here with us. But due to unavoidable circumstances, he's unable to be here with us and has asked me to stand in for him in the absence of our deputy governor, who is also in Abuja undergoing her induction course as a senator-elect. Personally, I'm a bit taken by surprise that we are gathered so soon for Professor Nimi Briggs, late Professor Nimi Briggs. You know, it calls to mind what Shakespeare said when he said, life is but a walking shadow. A poor player struts and frets his hour upon the stage and is heard no more. I believe that Professor Nimi Briggs will continue to be heard. If nothing, his works will continue to speak for him. His exemplary character and leadership will continue to speak, and his impact in academics, in medicine, and in leadership will continue to speak for him. I've always known him and respected him and admired him, but I got close to him when he was first research chairman and then later chairman of River State Elders and Economic Advisory Committee. I was then a commissioner. And one remarkable thing about him was that he could speak very bitter truth to power, but in a very calm and convincing tone. He was always very calm, very civil, very respectful to power, but he will never fail to tell the governor or the commissioners or anybody where you are going wrong and what better options he thinks are available for us to take. In fact, once he sees anything happening that he is not comfortable within your ministry, he will write to you telling you what is happening, ask you whether he can come and discuss with you or you want to come and discuss with him. And when you finish the discussions, he will go and write again the conversation and his recommendations and send a copy to you, the commissioner, send a copy to the governor recommending what should be done. In fact, I can tell you that up till date, his compilations, a very big book that he did as chairman of the River State Economic Advisory Committee, is still a very serious reference material in government in River State till date, 8 years after the publication of that document. That is the kind of man he was. And I said, I'm surprised that we are here today because, you know, I usually meet him here at Pleasure Park where he comes to exercise most times. And when you see him doing that, he's so energetic, so strong. Remember the last time I met him at the pleasure park, I walked up to him and told him, Prof, the way you are so strong, you look like somebody in your 60s, almost competing with those of us in our 50s. And he told me, well, it's the grace of God that he's 79. It's very soon that he'll be 79. And I told him how I pray, how I wish at 79, 80, I'll be as strong as you are. But lo and behold, we just had a sick, and then that he's, while trying to know what to do, the next thing that he's dead. We can only say it is well. We thank God that he lived a true Christian life and he made very monumental impact in our society. May his soul find rest in the bosom of the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, to take us further tonight, I want to call on Venerable Azeri for a very brief exhortation. Venerable Azeri, please.
The choir here, can we take the first stanza of the hymn, please? On a hill far away. Choir gone. All right, shall we please rise to pray? Eternal Father, you are good. And as we celebrate the life and times of your Son, whom you have called to glory, speak to us today again. And comfort us all by your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Please be seated. I want to thank God, for he has told us that in everything we should give thanks unto him. Number two, I want to thank God for the opportunity of gathering to celebrate a great man. The greatness of this man is a fact that is indisputable. We have all heard, we have spoken, we have read, and we have experienced and encountered him in several ways. I can comfortably say that the late Professor Emeritus Nimi Briggs, now branded as our father, lives. He lives in you, he lives in me, he lives in all of us, he lives in the works he has done. This evening, I want to draw us to 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 18, praying for what to say, even as I express gratitude to the organizers of this event, the state government, and the family for finding me worthy to do the exhortation. I prayed unto God, and he asked me to share with all of us from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 18. And I read, wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Comfort one another with these words. I believe that each and every one of us here seated who left his or her comfort to be here has a reason. It is a moment of mixed feelings to many of us, but the Bible says we should comfort one another. How? Which words? The first part of the words we should use in comforting ourselves are
the tributes we have heard, the ones we will read, the works he has done, we should comfort one another with these words. As a matter of fact, life is full of gatherings. People will gather for you. But there are two very important gatherings. If you look up, you find Professor Nimi Briggs, 1944, am I right? 1944 to 2003. So it tells us that there are two important seasons in a life, the entrance and the exit. 1944, people gathered to celebrate the birth of this man. And there were other gatherings surrounding his birth. 2003, we are here gathered. Several gatherings have taken place. We have gathered here, and several other gatherings will take place for his death. We are living in a time-space reality. Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, to everything there is a time, there is a season, and there is a purpose. A time to be born and a time to die. This is a reality that we face, each and every one of us. But in between the first gathering of our birth to the last gathering of our death, what shall we be known for? And if I should ask a second question of why are we here? Actually, we are here to render tributes. It is good for us to remind ourselves what this word is. I checked the Oxford English Dictionary defines the word tribute as an act, a statement, or a gift that is intended to show gratitude, respect, or admiration or affection to a person. And this forms the core of what I want to share with us. Number one, we have gathered. Excellent. An act. We have spoken. Also an act. We have made statements. But there is one thing that I believe is left to be done. And that is the gift to show our respect, to show our admiration, to show our affection to this great father, to this great man who have a global impact. What are those gifts we should give unto him? First of all, I thank the Secretary to the State Government for complimenting a fact that was raised by the sister. All of the things that were said here, little were said about this man's Christian life. The father we are celebrating today was a devout Christian. And so we have the boldness, we have the gladness to speak that he rests in the bosom of the Lord. We have no doubt. Now, what shall we give unto him? The first gift that we should give unto him to maintain the immortality of his person is the gift of emulating his life. All that have been said here, we should emulate. We should replicate and perpetuate them. That is gift number one. Gift number two is we heard that he had a special love in saving the lives of women and children. And as a matter of fact, there is an issue about a woman that needs justice as a gift to crown this man's life. When we say, let us comfort one another with these words, the state government, the family, and every one of us needs comfort. But the family with which I got to know this man, the church, King's Chapel, 4 Harley Street, Old GRA Port Harcourt, it's a church I believe, it's a family I believe that we should even comfort the more. The shock of the departure of our father has not gone off our hearts. Then here comes a woman, a parishioner of the church, a member of the same family, Dame Boma Amaomu Jombo, that was gruesomely murdered at her residence. And I know, I believe, that seated here are people who can push for justice, that such thing may not happen to anyone again. I believe something can be done to forestall future occurrences. Today is Amaomu Jombo. Tomorrow, we don't know the next woman that could be attacked. I submit, beloved people of God and everyone here, that we should please try to give this man this gift in finding justice as concerns the death, the murder of this woman. The last gift, which I think is most important, is the gift of our lives to Christ. Seated here, have we given our lives to Christ? We are rejoicing because this great man has gone to be with the Lord. Each and every one of us will go through this course, for there is a time to be born and a time to die. It is appointed unto man once to die, once to be born, once to die, and next judgment. And death can come to any of us anytime, anyhow, anywhere, any day. If death comes to me today, where will I be? Will I spend the rest of my life in hell or in heaven? The truth remains that there are people who disagree about the existence of heaven and hell. That is a deceit of all times. As long as we all know that this world, all things visible and invisible, are created by the spoken word of God, the word of God that is revealed in the Bible stands sure. And this is what I want to read unto us from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, from verse 13, as I conclude, I read, "But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope." Someone who dies in Christ, someone who has given his or her life to Christ, dies in hope. The Bible describes such a person as one who sleeps. You recall in John chapter 11, in the death of Lazarus, when the news came to Jesus, he told his disciples, "I go to wake Lazarus from sleep." So all those who die giving their lives to Christ are sleeping in the Lord. So is our departed father. What will befall us when that time comes? So it will be of a great honor, a great gift indeed, if through this occasion of his death, we re-examine our relationship with God and truly surrender our lives unto him. These are the things that are so important unto us today to continue in immortalizing our great father, this great icon of all times. And there will be great joy in his heart and even in heaven that we, someone here has given his or her life to Christ. Dearly beloved in the Lord, these are the words with which we will comfort ourselves. And verse 14 tells us, if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus, God will bring with him. So we are confident that our Father, in the words of Keka, as a brand now, is with the Lord. Where will you be when this day comes unto you? Shall we rise as we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you. Give us the grace to live our lives pleasing unto you, to render worthy services to you and to humanity as your departed son, the late Professor Emeritus Nimi Briggs, has showed the way. Help us, O Lord, to do that which is right in your sight, especially as it concerns emulating the good life of this man, giving him the gift of justice, and giving our lives unto you. Comfort the family. Comfort the state. Comfort the country, and indeed the world. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Amen. Thank you so much, Venerable. Ladies and gentlemen, we just have one more item and we'll round up today's event. So just be a bit patient. In the next 5 minutes, we should be out of this venue. Ladies and gentlemen, to invite to the microphone for his vote of thanks, our chief mourner, architect Nina Briggs.
Good evening, everyone. The night is far spent, so I'll try and be very, very quick. On behalf of my mother, on behalf of my sisters, on behalf of my wife, my brother-in-law, on behalf of the grandchildren and the entire extended family, I'd like to render a heartfelt thanks to the following: the executive governor of the state, ably here represented, secretary to the state government, the chief of staff, members of the State Executive Council, Her Excellency the Governor-elect, members of the River State Government, members of Bayelsa State Government, members of the medical community, royal fathers, people of Abonima, people of River State, and Nimi's community at large. I'd like to thank each and every one of you. Any omission on my part is not only unintended, it's deeply regrettable. And to the students of Uniport that put up that incredible drama piece, thank you very much. I would like to close by saying the family right now is having a loss, a personal loss. It's grieving a personal loss. However, we also find that it's more of a communal loss because there are so many people in society across the nation that are suffering this loss as well. We're all together in this. But I see it as a communal opportunity. I see it as a community opportunity in the sense that if Nimi touched you in one way or the other, if my father touched you in one way or the other, I would encourage you to leave here identifying what reason you think he touched you, what area he think he touched you in, and amplify that area in your life, whether it's honesty, whether it's diligence, whether it's hard work, whether it's transparency, whether it's forthrightness, whether it's speaking to the truth, as one of the speakers mentioned. I would encourage you to find whatever it is and build on it, so that jointly we can not only build a better nation, but we can uphold his legacy. He has played his part and he has left. I'd encourage each and every one of us here to play our part in this journey of life. So once again, on behalf of my mother, on behalf of my sisters, on behalf of my wife, my brother-in-law, the grandchildren, and the entirety of Nimi's extended family, I'd like to thank each and every one of you for taking out time to join us this evening. A heartfelt thanks to the River State Government for putting this together. Thank you very much and have a good evening. God bless.
Thank you very much, Architect Nina Briggs. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of today's event. I'll leave you in the hands of the Royal Mail Choir as it sings us out of the venue. My name is Mudiaga. Together with my colleague Sele, we've been your anchors for tonight. Good night.
Thank you. Hallelujah.